to another commentary. This channel is a commentary channel. I have briefly flirted with AI animated, and I'm going to continue to do this, but I thought I would make a video addressing a comment that was left on one of my old videos about Buvidal. And the comment was asking how basically it works. Now, I first want to let you know that I was taking orally Junista, which is an opioid, since 2015. But since 2004, I was on some type of opioid, whether at one stage it was fentanyl patches, another time it was oxycodone. So I've been up till 2 years ago, I was taking opioids. And my doctor at the time said to me, "Jim, how about Buvidal?" And he said, "I'm not going to push you into it. You go home and you check it out. And if you want it, I'll do it." And I did check it out, and I found out that it was an injection for me, a monthly injection, instead of having to take Junistas. Now, I must let you know dosage. I was on 32 milligrams of Junista a day, and I transferred over to 96 milligrams of Buvidal per month. But that wasn't holding me, and I was taking opioids for pain. I had a work accident in 1997, and I had surgery in the early 2000s, 4 lots, and they failed. They actually made the situation worse. And I've been to the pain clinic twice. So anyway, 96 wasn't holding me, so I'm presently on 128 meg or mmg of Buvidal. Now, Buvidal is dangerous. They won't give it to the patient. Either the chemist will take it to the doctor, or the doctor will pick it up from the chemist. And the reason why it is dangerous is because once it's injected, it forms into a gel. So you can imagine if you abuse this and it's turning into a gel and you're injecting it into your veins, you could cause a blockage and possibly death. Now, how they do it is they inject it either in your arm or your abdomen. I get mine done in my abdomen, in the fatty subcutaneous tissue, because I've just told you, you can't inject it into the vein. It has to be into your fat. And I also want to tell you, it's similar to what diabetics do. So the same sort of process. So they pinch a bit of my abdomen, say this is my abdomen, and they'll put it in and slowly press the liquid in. Once the liquid gets in, it instantly forms a gel, and it may sting for a few seconds depending on where they put it, because they have to alternate. One time I'll go in and it'll be on my left side, the next time they'll go in and it'll be on my right side. I think this is to prevent scarring. Now, When it's injected, do you get off your face like opioids? No. So it's not, you don't get a rush. It's nothing like that. It is like an opioid partial antagonist. So that means that when I take Buvidal, I cannot take opioids because they won't do anything for me. It will block them from working. But I'm also going to explain about the blood serum levels. Now, because I have my injection monthly, every time I have an injection, I don't suddenly get another rush up to 128 megs. From the first time they reach that level in my blood, so for the whole month, it stays constant at a constant level. So I'll come along 4 weeks later and have an injection. It won't, my blood levels don't suddenly increase. It just maintains that level. If I decide that I don't want that injection, after 6 weeks, the blood level serums will tend to dip. So the reason for Buvidal is to stop you from feeling sick. So you know, if you're an opioid user, whether you use it properly or whether you use it illicitly, what can happen is, let's just for argument's sake here say we're using it illicitly. When you have, so we're using it IV, okay? So we have a hit and we have a rush, and then that may last 6-8 hours, and then next minute we're sick and we're throwing up and we have to get our next fix. Buvidal is different to that. Buvidal stops you from hanging out. So Buvidal stops all those sick feelings. So you don't get high off it, but you don't, it's a good pain relief, and you don't feel sick because there's no come down. Because if you constantly get your injection, however often it is, that leaves that blood level, as I was talking about, at that same rate. It is only after a certain time that the blood levels will drop. Now, this person who left a comment was getting quite a small dose. So I think if they're getting a small dose, they may be getting, they didn't stipulate, but I would assume that that may be weekly, because that was such a small dose. But anyway, if it is weekly or whatever the time period is, the doctor who, or the nurse practitioner who injects you, every time that's injected, it will reach a certain level in your bloodstream. So if he increases, this person was on 8 milligrams, I think the comment was, so say he increases it to 16, then the blood level would go up to 16, and it would stay for that whole time period until you had your next injection at 16. It's only after a certain length of time, like with me, as I said, I'm on 128. I think they go up in 28s. I think the next one is 156. I'm not sure about that. I don't know of anyone who's on that dose. I only know of people, it seems that people or doctors are maxing people out, and this is Australia, on 128. Now, where I live on the Sunshine Coast in Queensland, and when I first got it done, only one doctor was doing it. I didn't happen to like this particular doctor. He was getting old and he was starting to make mistakes. So I found a new doctor, and this new doctor had to do training. So they have to do training to be able to administer this drug. In different countries, we have different classifications of drugs. So Buvidal is still classified as the same as opioids, and opioids in Australia is an S8. So Buvidal is still like an S8. Buvidal is still partly an opioid, but it's got I'm not very clever with explaining to you the actual chemical components. It is partly an opioid, but it's also an opioid antagonist. So in other words, all those long acting opioids I can't take, and I have to have a little warning card that I'm on Buvidal. So if anything happens to me and I go to emergency, I present this card so they don't give me like a fentanyl injection, but I can take fast relief like endones. I hope that's helped and made sense. So we are not as well, I don't know about anywhere else in the world. I can only speak for Queensland, Australia, and where I live. So now where I live on the Sunshine Coast, there's only two doctors who have the certificate to be able to give you Buvidal. Other doctors seem to be frightened about it. So, and they also stigmatize you that you are a drug addict. And I never abused opioids. I abused ice and meth. But I was dependent on opioids because I had been using since 2004. And I think it was mid-2022 when they swapped me over to Buvidal. And since swapping over, I don't even suffer from constipation. You know, opioids, you suffer constipation. And I can't tell you truthfully that I am completely pain-free, because that's a lie. There is no drug that completely sets you free from pain all the time. And the actual thing is, opioids was never meant for chronic pain. Opioids was meant for acute pain. But the pharmaceutical companies got really greedy and pushed opioids on doctors. And then doctors started handing out this opioids to people who had chronic pain, and found that with opioids, and this is the difference, with opioids, to get the same effect, you have to have more and more, higher and higher of the dosage, where with Buvidal, you only reach a certain level in your blood and you can't go any higher. So you don't get off your face, but you don't come down. So Buvidal is the way to go. And as I said, there's only two doctors here on the Sunshine Coast who do it. And I think if you were an addict and you wanted to go, this is Queensland, and you wanted to go on Buvidal, either you have to go to one of these two doctors, or you'd probably go to AODS, which stands for Alcohol and Drug Services, and there they'd probably put you on Subutex, or what's that other, it's on the tip of my head, methadone. Buvidal is a very new thing here in Australia. It's not so new now, but when I was first put on it, there was only like in Queensland, I was about like the 102nd patient, so it was fairly new. Fortunately, it's catching on. This new doctor that I go to, who had to learn and get a certificate and being able to do Buvidal, has now got another patient who was opioid dependent, and they're now doing very well on Buvidal injections. And I don't think that I'm ever going to be free from having something in my system, because it was like 17 years of opioids before they changed me to Buvidal. So I hope that's answered your question. I'm always here to help. If you do have any more and I miss a comment, please email me at jamamberstone@gmail.com. All right. Love, light, and blessings. Cherish every moment. Every life matters. And thank you very much for watching. Bye for now, and good luck to that person. All the best.